Me. Check, check, check. So you're saying that's on, is it? Ready to go. Good evening, hockey fans, and welcome to the Charles V. Keating Millennium Center. I'm Kevin McNeil, along with Paul McDonald. It is the Keating Cup from the campus of St. Francis Xavier University. And Paul, unfortunately, due to weather conditions, this has come down to a one-game showdown between the McGill Redmen and the Santa Fe X-Men. Both teams are swinging back into action.
Yeah, it's too bad they couldn't be playing on a more regular basis. We have McGill, one of the top teams in the country, and Santa Fe started off four straight wins. And, you know, it's just good to get back at it after, I think, 28 days off, 29 days off for Santa Fe playing their last game on November 30th here at home, a 4-0 win over Dalhousie.
Well, as far as the visiting team tonight, the McGill Redmen, Paul, they've come in to tonight's hockey game with a record of 16-0-2, both games having gone to the shootout. So certainly some stiff competition here tonight in the Keating Cup.
That's right, and it's good for McGill to come down east, arguably the best division or conference in all CIS hockey. So it'll be a good test for McGill.
Well, it certainly will. The McGill Redmen, coached by Kelly Nobes, and they'll send a few guys out here for the hockey game here tonight. Mark Hulshoff is the referee tonight. Brian McDonald, John McDonnell will be your two linesmen. We'll have the playing off for National Anthem. We'll be back with the opening face-off here. It is the Keating Cup. Here this evening from the Charles V. Keating Millennium Center. Game between the McGill Redmen and the Santa Fe X-Men.
Not a big crowd here tonight. Of course, the road's not the best here in the Antigonish area, but it's nice to get out over the break to get a chance to watch two of the stronger teams in the country play off or play in a one-game showdown, but it's just good to get back playing.
Well, we're just about set and ready to go here this evening from Antigonish, Nova Scotia. Hope everyone enjoyed the holidays. I know talking with Brad Fettel prior to the hockey game tonight, Paul, he was looking forward to getting back into action, almost a month off. Boy, when you prepare for hockey season, all of a sudden you take a month off, it's like starting all over again.
Absolutely. I mean, as we just talked about, it was November 30th, their last game. And, you know, it's a long time. They had exams since then. And then they went home for a little bit, so it's good to get back, get some skates in, and get the rust out.
Well, we are underway here from the Millennium Center. Mangan Morrison and Bryce Swan up front for the Centivex X-Men. Back on the X-Men blue line is going to be Artie Chisholm, along with number five, Spencer McAvoy. The X-Men dressed in their home white jerseys. The McGill Redmen will wear their road red with white trim as the X-Men pick the puck up at center ice. Morrison can't play it. Artie Chisholm will get a piece of his man. Yeah, the puck now bouncing inside the McGill blue line, chasing it down. They're going to be the Redmen. That pass intercepted. Mangan lost his footing, fell down, back up quickly, and he'll shovel it off to the right of the starting goaltender, Antoine Tardif. Lots of players on this McGill Hockey Club that have spent their previous career in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League. Centivex clear the blue line, and the puck taken again, once again by the McGill Redmen, as Benjamin Morse will backpedal behind his goaltender, Tardif. Early going here. Period number one, the Keating Cup. One game showdown, winner takes all. The X-Men have won this Keating Cup since its inception in 2006. Here's a chance now as Bast strided in, but he was beaten to the puck by Tardif. And away comes the captain now for McGill, Boston. He turned the puck over. Aaron passes. Ryan McKiernan steps in and intercepts, and he'll flip a high one over the goaltender, Brian Gillis, who starts tonight. Back up, Joey Perricone just getting in here tonight after a couple of delays, flights from California. Certainly no snow there, but plenty of Antigonish.
That's right. We were pretty lucky until the last couple of days, but we're starting to catch up to the rest of the country, I think. But it's been a pretty good winter so far.
Still awaiting the first goal of the hockey game, as it's Valentin to pick it up for the Redmen through center ice. Nifty backhand feed. Boisvert will catch up with it and slash it in a little deeper. Going back to pick it up is going to be R.D. Chisholm. This exhibition hockey game, an opportunity for perhaps... Gillis shot safe! They score the Redmen finally after an outstanding stop by Brian Gillis. The rebound there, and not a whole lot of opportunity for the goaltender Gillis after he made a stellar first stop.
Quick turnover at the blue line. Quick shot on the net. Great right leg save by Gillis, however. McGill Redmen forward able to put that one home to make it 1-0 here, 2 minutes 15 seconds into the first period. I'm not sure who got
it. I believe Longpre Poirier was the goal scorer for the Redmen. We'll get the official announcement here in a moment. And it looked like Brian Gillis was going to make back-to-back stops there, but just couldn't find a second one. No fault of the goaltender. So Poirier, the goal scorer for the Redmen. And it is the Redmen leading 1-0. As that shot off the stick of the Centivex defenseman, Josh Day, finds its way into the cresting of the goaltender, Tardif, and he'll hold on to it. Faceoff coming inside the McGill blue line.
Well, it is Longpre Poirier with the goal from Boisvert at the 2:15 mark of the first period. And Longpre Poirier has had a pretty good solid start to the season with 6 goals in 18 regular season games.
Now the X-Men trying to come up with a puck in the neutral zone. Scott Brennan wearing number 72. Battling there with the McGill forward, Picard. And it's Alexander Picard dropping for Vero. Rink wide the shot there, and that goes just wide of the goal. Top two goal scorers for the McGill Redmen on the ice, Picard Hooper and Francis Vero-Paul. McGill, Dorion trying to hold in loose puck, and it's Matt Bragg trying to come up with it, not able to do so. As Lewis, the ex-defenseman, back to pick it up. Jason Day will take the feed. He'll back it up a little further to Lewis. His long lead pass travels up and into the X bench, I believe, and out of play, so we'll get a stoppage here with 16:46 to go in the opening period. McGill up 1-0.
Vero Paul and Picard Hooper also leading Canada in points this season with 39 and 38 points respectively. And, of course, Vero Paul played a number of years with Chicoutimi in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League. 301 games played. Didn't really show the offensive skill that he showed the last couple seasons. Last year he had 54 points to tie for third overall in Canada, of course, with Hunter Tremblay from UNB. So he's really turned it on. This is third season with the McGill Redmen.
Faceoff coming outside the Centivex blue line. Sean Donovan on the back end for Centivex with Nick Pageau up front. going to be Murdoch McClellan. Rob Warner also on the wing, and Eric McKenna, number 42 for the center back X-Men. McGill coming up with the puck inside their own zone. He'll pass up the left wing side. Sean Donovan will step off in front of it, lays it off the glass. Knocked down by a high stick. It appears to be okay as Eric McKenna will drag it back in off that right side. McKenna trying to swing it wide, forced behind the net. Warner trying to come up with it for St. of X as the Redmen rolled it up the wing. Claffey steps in. McKenna runs into his man full tilt, and they continue the battle for the puck on the far wing. Backhander sent around by Vincent Bourgeois, former Montreal Junior. Two-on-two battle pursues, and Bourgeois again on the puck behind his own goal for the Redmen. Lifted off the wall and down ice. That puck will get up on end, and that will be an icing call against McGill as the Redmen lead the hockey game by a score of 1-0.
There's no doubt X will really have to try to slow this McGill squad down. They're quick. We saw some great breakout passes starting with their defensemen to get out of their zone, and X really have to be aware of the forwards getting in behind their defensemen.
Faceoff to the left of Antoine Turdip. Started his career with the Acadie Bathurst T10. I believe finished it up with the Drummondville Voltigeur. There's a shot off the outside of the post. X now with a flurry. But the puck is picked up by McGill as they look to get it outside the line. And they do. Day of the defenseman for X to Lewis. Lewis with a backhand fed up. Here's Brent Morrison. Cuts in. Striding down the left side. Late man coming. The shot there. Ripped right on by Mangan. Outstanding stop by Turdip as Mangan got all of that one for sure.
That was a nice pass, cross his own pass by Morrison. However, it was easy read by Antoine Turdip as he was able to get over and really set up shop in front of the net with Bryce Swan coming in looking for the rebound. But a nice hard shot from the point from Phil Mangan.
Face off to the left of Turdip, the starting goaltender this evening for the Redmen. Center back's trying to come up with it. Chris Hewlett walks in on touch out front. We're undershooting. He was tied up in the last second. And again, McGill on the counterattack. Right side is Boisvert. Lots of speed. Pajol cut him off the pass. Sent around the net by undershoot. Hewlett waits for the puck. Back to undershoot. Up the right side. And here comes Bass. That puck floating wide as Bass was taken into the goal. And we will get a stoppage as Jason Bass, looking for a little give and go, he went hard to the net.
Dorion did a good job there just getting the stick out, deflecting it in the sideboards, and then Bass went into Dorion, taking the net off its moorings, and it's taken outside the McGill zone.
Well, McGill lead the hockey game 1-0 on a goal by Poirier. 14:47 here to go in the first period. Keating Cup from the Millennium Center in Antigonish. As we're back underway, and once again it is McGill controlling that puck in the faceoff. They try to rip it up the wing. Poirier dumps it in. Undershoot will step in front. Fed off to center. And it's broken up there as Pajot try to go through the middle of the ice. Hewlett will cut it off the blue line. Sending off in front. And Jason Bass couldn't trap it onto his stick blade as he avoids a hit there into the corner on the near side. Again, it is McGill coming up with it, and they get it to center ice. X-Men dump it in, and they'll make changes on the fly. McGill will control it once again as they look to come through the middle of the ice. Puck is dumped in by Boisvert. He'll go to the bench on a change. Sean Donovan back for the X-Men. Being watched on the play there by Picard. Puck is deflected out by the X-Men as Benjamin Morse goes back to pick it up for McGill. Ripped up on the right side. Barrow, nice job to knock it out of midair. Morse gets it to the blue line, and that is going to be an offside call against McGill with 13:44 here to go in the first period. A kind of a typical start is what we expected, Paul. Both teams a little bit rusty and trying to work the turkey out.
And a long trip, obviously, for McGill coming down, the last night's game being postponed. But you can see they get a lot of skill coming up through the zone. Alexander Picard, number 9, hit 57 goals one season with Bay Camo in the Quebec League, so he knows what to do with the puck.
Finished his career with the St. John Sea Dogs. I'm not sure if he lived up to expectations there, but he certainly has here. Coach Kelly Knobs and the McGill Redmen. It's the AUS against the OUA as that shot. I'm not sure if it got through or not, but it certainly was blocked as it's picked up by Bragg. He turns in the corner on the near side. McGill trying to clear that puck out. Sedevac's trying to hold it in. Sent around as Bragg is checked closely there by the defenseman Bourgeois. And the X-Men have to backpedal as McGill come across the checkered red line. Vero in. He gets checked by Jason Day, but he continues on. Francis Vero Paul. Warner trying to get it out, unable to do so. And then Vero Paul is knocked down by Eric McKenna. And we talked about Francis Vero Paul and his scoring ability here in this league. One thing he did very well in Chicoutimi, well, he was a real agitator. And boy, did they love him in Chicoutimi.
Well, he had a good first season. I believe he had 24, 27 points, but to come out and have 54 last year and already with 26 regular season goals, really turned it up a couple notches, but he showed some good speed coming down there, drew the penalty on Eric McKenna as McKenna comes in and could have got a couple different calls, but got one for interference.
Well, off the faceoff, the X-Men successful in clearing that puck all the way down ice as Antoine Tardif out to play it. And the Redmen looking to take a 2-0 lead here as they hit the game's first power play. And the Redmen spread it across the blue line, coming to the slot area as it's going to be Marcotte, but he can't do much with it. Murdoch McCullen sends it wide of the goal. McCullen certainly a solid penalty killer. He'll go to the bench on a change, and again it is McGill through center ice. Marcotte down that right aisle, puts on the brakes. Boston captain will go to the front of the goal. Worked off to that far left point to McKiernan. Marcotte, he waits on the near side. It's McKiernan, a little give and go there with the Poirier, and it's McGill trying to get the puck deep. Benjamin Morse, the other defenseman, leaning on him is going to be Claffey, turned over, and here is McGill up with a shot right on Gillis to save the rebound. Steered to that far corner. Boston able to hold control of the puck. Work back to the right blue line to McKiernan. He looks to the front of the goal. Across to Morse. Morse will return it to McKiernan, looking to switch off, and they'll do just that. As the X-Men doing a good job, though, at keeping the Redmen to the outside, Paul.
One good scoring chance. Claffey had a chance to get the puck out, but as soon as it was lost in his feet, there was two McGill Redmen players on top of him. But as you said, everything to the outside. One good scoring chance, but Gillis made a great save with the shoulder. 43 seconds left in the McKenna interference call. And 11:32 left here in the first period.
Face off to the right of Brian Gillis. Paul mentioned Sedevac's last game, a 4-0 win over Dalhousie. It was Joey Periconi picking up the shutout in that hockey game. Picard trying to move that puck down low for the McGill Redmen. Certainly Picard, no stranger to the power play. Here's a feed to Boisvert. He turns, fires it cross ice in that first circle. Vero will back it up to the blue line. McGill again working to the outside. Dorion gets it back. He'll shoot it. That's off the outside of the post. Puck rolling to the line. Dorion not able to hold it in. Defensive player of the year, CIS last season, Marc-Andre Dorion. And attended the Toronto Maple Leafs rookie camp this season. Vero will swing it in back of the Sedevac goal. Pageau trying to work it up the far wall. The penalty has expired. McKenna out of the box. And it's Mangan not able to handle that feed. Down ice comes Picard. And he'll wrap it around the wall. Nice play. Deflected ahead to Morrison. He gets his hit up in the last second. McKiernan had him all lined up.
What a play by McKiernan to come across and make that 2-on-1 and take control.
Here come the X-Men again. A shot. Save. Rebound. They score. Dave, the defenseman, I believe, had jumped up on the play. He had the wide open 24 square feet. Stared him down. And he made no mistake there.
Kenny, I played a little bit of hockey with you, and I think you'd have buried that one. Wide open net is a great transition game at the blue line by X to take it in. And Tardif gets caught over to the left side, and wide open. Dale never get an easier goal than that.
He certainly will not. That's a good one for the X-Men, though, as they find their feet here with 10:24 to go in the opening period, and they've tied a hockey game up. And it comes to the heels of a great penalty kill as well. Undershoot, Bast and Hewlett up front for the X-Men. McAvoy and Day on the blue line. Back to pick it up is going to be McAvoy. He'll paddle it up the far side, deflected in by Undershoot. It'll roll wide of the goal. And an icing call coming against the Sedevac X-Men with exactly 10 minutes here to go in the first period.
Day from Mangan and Morrison at the 9:36 mark. The even strength marker has made it 1-1 here. Shots are 5-4 in favor of McGill. Faceoff deep in the Sanivec zone to the right of goaltender Brian Gillis.
Shots are 5-4. As Paul McDonald just mentioned, certainly wide open here, Paul. And we saw in the last hockey game, the 4-0 win, there didn't seem to be a whole lot of whistles in that game. There doesn't seem to be a whole lot either. A little bit of freewheeling on both sides.
Well, and that's kind of nice to see. You don't want to see a big defensive showdown here tonight. You want to everybody get their skating legs back and get some passes in. You want to see some good hockey, and so far that's what we've seen.
And as bad as you want to play these exhibition games and get yourself back in top form, you also hate to lose a player to injury in an exhibition series that really doesn't mean a whole lot.
Yeah, I think that's why you'll see both teams rolling four lines. It really doesn't mean a whole lot here tonight, but you're right, you don't want to get anybody hurt.
I do believe both hockey clubs have seven defensemen dressed, so it's one over the limit. They chose to do that for this Keating Cup. Ernie Chisholm trying to get it up ice. Bass will knock it down. Down that left side for undershoot. He is checked very quickly as the X-Men move it inside the McGill offensive zone. Donovan has to back off. And here comes Marcotte. Sends it on that left side to Vossen. He is stopped in his tracks. And another offside called against the Redmen with 9:12 here to go in this first period.
And that's one difference I see in this league as opposed to Quebec League. The defenseman will jump up at the blue line on 2-on-2s. Nick Pajot did a great job there, forcing the McGill forward offside. A lot of times in the Quebec League, you'll see the players back in on top of the goaltender and giving up a good scoring chance. So if you can attack at the blue line, it really takes away scoring chances.
McKenna, Warner, and McCollum, the combination up front for Red Petal and the X-Men. Center X coming up with the puck at the blue line, now to center. And jumping up was Morse, the defenseman for McGill. It is batted in by Guillaume Doucette. As Gillis very alertly out of the goal to play it up that far wing. Through center ice, Murdoch McClellan from skate blade to stick blade. Down and up that right wing side, trying to wrap wide around the Redmen defenseman. McClellan still on the puck. To the point that Claffey fires a shot. Where's it? Scores! Back of the net. Turner thought he had it. But I think it was Warner, perhaps.
I think it was Eric McKenna. McKenna. That's, I think, the second game I've broadcast over the years he's played, and he scored the both times that he's been in the lineup. Come a long way since that first year Adam AA with me, let me tell you.
He's lucky to get this far with you as head coach, but McKenna gets a goal. The X-Men are up 2-1. And again, for Brad Fettel, a chance to get some of these guys a little extra ice time that maybe don't see it during the regular season.
Well, you know with Eric, he's going to drive the net every chance he gets, and it's nice to see him get rewarded on that play.
Well, a super shot by Claffey, the defenseman. You like to have it to ankle high. That's exactly where it was. Turner thought he had it. McKenna able to dump in that rebound. So the X-Men with their first lead of the hockey game. As McGill with the puck inside their blue line. Now they quickly come to center ice. Verona, 2-on-1, will finesse it ahead. Picard not able to reach it. Delayed penalty coming here against the X-Men. As Mark Hulshoff, the referee, will call a hooking penalty against the X-Men. And it's going to be the Centivex defenseman, Spencer McAvoy, who maybe got caught a bit and tried to get back a little bit.
Well, when the speed of McGill just jumps around to make it a 2-on-1, he tries to even it up a little with a little tug on the sweater with the stick, and Alshoff makes has no hesitation there, makes the call. So they go with a chance now to even the game up at 2 with 8:01 left here in the first.
Second power play of the hockey game for the McGill Redmen, 0-for-1. Centivex scored shortly after they killed off the first power play. Let's see how they manage here. The X-Men with a 2-1 lead. 7:45 here to go in the opening period. That puck dangerously off in front. Gillis played it. And then a quick shot finds the glove off the ex-goaltender, and he's going to freeze frame the play.
Doucette just flicked that puck one-handed on Gillis after it just came off the stanchion right on front of the net, and that would have been a bad break for Saint-Evex. Now during the first power play, X were solid in keeping everything to the outside with McGill and pressuring the pass, and that's something that all good penalty kills do. They pressure the pass. Then they follow the puck and try to disrupt it.
Talked a little bit about Vero, Paul, and Picard up front, but certainly this power play starts with Marc-Andre Dorion. He is the catalyst and the quarterback in every good power fight, Paul. Doesn't matter what level, always has a great quarterback.
Absolutely. You get the puck back to the point, whether they look to the side for old Paul, or who's got 10 power play markers in the regular season, or just fire it on the net. You have to have a plan.
McGill coming up with the puck for old Paul in the corner. Now we'll dish it off that far corner to Picard. He is watched closely there by Brennan Ray. Now to the left point, McGill. We'll spread it out and set it up. Dorion steps in. Nice pass to Vero Paul, and he whiffed on it. Picked up by the X-Men's Donovan, who cannot clear the puck out. Dorion to Alexander Picard Hooper into the corner. As the Redmen again kept to the outside. And finally, the Centivex X-Men deliver the puck down ice. McKiernan will quickly bring it back inside the X zone. He's by himself, and it's going to be Brent Morrison to pick it up and slap it all the way down.
McKiernan on that play would have been more advised just to dump that puck deep. He had no support, and it was easy clear for Centivex.
Lawson, the captain, right side, trying to come to the middle of the ice again. Centivex cover it well, and the X-Men will bring it to center. Morrison will pull up. There's the pass for Murdoch McClellan. He sidesteps a hit from Marcotte. Lawson will get a piece of him, but McClellan, the veteran, able to knock it inside the McGill blue line. Penalty has expired. McAvoy steps back onto the ice. Another outstanding job done by the Centivex PK. Holding on to the control of the puck will be the Redmen. Marcotte at the point. Fires it right on Gillis. The stop down in the butterfly style. And he's able to make the stop there. His seventh of the hockey game.
He gets out on top of the crease area, and he's able to see that beautifully. Bryce Swan came out just to try to get in the way, and then at the last second he realized that he better get the stick out of there, not to deflect anything. So an easy save by Gillis, who made sure he really cut the angle down.
Face off to the left of the X-Men goaltender, Brian Gillis. Phil Mangan taking the draw for the X-Men against Daniel Conacher. Not the McGill Redmen. McGill again able to win the faceoff, trying to come up with that loose puck, center of X. Led by Bryce Swan, get to it. He'll absorb the hit in that far corner. It is nudged ahead to Brett Morrison down the right side. Morrison looking for the late man. It is picked up by Chisholm. The shot right on as he did not hesitate in jumping up. Nice vision shown there by the X-forward. And an icing call coming here against McGill. But a great opportunity for R.D. Chisholm.
Morrison really took the third possible pass. And it was R.D. Chisholm coming in. And Chisholm with the quick low shot. And a good save by Tardif with Bryce Swan just at the crease area trying to knock that one home. So good scoring chance once again for Centivex.
5-on-5 hockey with 5:15 here to play in the opening period. Bouncing puck, Chris Hewlett not able to tame it. And it's going to be McGill back off of center ice. Ahead it comes to Poirier, and he is in ahead of the play. And we'll get a stoppage in play. This X-Men hockey webcast is coming to you live on SSN Canada, the streaming sports network. Visit the streaming sports network at www.ssncanada.ca. SSN, your sports anywhere, anytime. 2-1 hockey game with exactly 5 minutes to play here in period number one. The X-Men fell behind 1-0, but two goals back-to-back have given Centivex the 2-1 lead. Shots are 8 aside.
Holding call being called by referee Halshoff to McGill, and it looks like it will be Alain-Pierre Poirier going off with 4:53 left in the first period. So a tough penalty to take in the opposition zone. A good chance for X to up the lead to 2.
Face-off will happen to the left of Antoine Tardif, who has faced 8 shots and has made 6 stops. And I'll mention the X-Men enjoy their first opportunity. McGill are 0-2 currently in this opening period with the man advantage. Bass will take the draw for the X-Men. Undershoot up off the right side. Scott Brandon will occupy the left wing. Yielded on the point. Joining him, McAvoy. Another X-defenseman. Centerbacks controlled it inside the McGill blue line. Undershoot looks back across to Bass. The shot by McAvoy. Toe stop by Tardif. McAvoy will hold that puck in for the X-Men. Hewlett trying to get it across. Forced it. Nice play by Levesque, and it's sent down ice by McGill.
That's a tough little pass there by Hewlett. Luckily for X, it wasn't taken down the ice in a breakaway.
Center of X now trying to get it up ice on this power play. Bass to center ice. He'll dump it in, undershoot, tied up a bit in traffic. Finally, we'll catch up with the puck as he absorbs the hit in the far corner. Play happening to the left of Tardif, the goaltender for the McGill Redmen. Centivac's pushing it right to left here. As McAvoy will shoot it. Rebound, save, scores, and the rebound. Undershoot, I believe, on the doorstep. Tardif couldn't control the rebound, and he's able to bat it in. And the X-Men on the power play lead it 3-1.
I like what McAvoy did there. He didn't wait for pressure in front of the net. He took that quick little snapshot, and Tardif wasn't able to keep the rebound, and Undershoot was able to put that one home. And a power play marker at the 16-minute mark of the first period has given Centivac a 3-1 lead.
Well, rebounds have kind of been what has bit Tardif in the past. And here tonight on two goals, they're both saves, but rebounds, one that he couldn't control, and two that his defenseman couldn't clear.
Yeah, that was just a big break there for X, but again, you need some support in front of the net.
Here's Wright with a drive off the right side for McGill. He whistled it over top of the net. Vero is checked on the play by Brennan Ray. Up to Bragg, he didn't see his man coming in off the blue line. McGill trying to answer quickly now, trailing 3-1. Vero on the right aisle will spin away from Brennan Ray. He hounds him, but the Redmen keep control of the puck. Vero dish it behind the net. Picard checked on the play and watched closely. And he'll try to cycle that puck. Comes off in front, getting to it, Sean Donovan. And he is going to clear it out for the Centivac X-Men. 3:10 here to go in the opening period. X up 3-1. Donovan looked like he might dump it in, but decided to carry it in. Then takes a heavy hit. Donovan's going to head to the bench on a change.
A good move there to get the red line before he dumped it in. It would have been icing, and then he collided heavily with Genet, Hubert Genet, just inside the McGill side of the red line.
Centivacs again through the middle of the ice. Morrison not able to pick that pass up, and that is going to be an icing call against the X-Men. With now 2:47 here to play in the first period, the X-Men, the home team tonight, leading 3-1.
Claffey with a tough pass, trying to hit Morrison coming through the center zone, but way behind him, and easy icing call against Centivac.
5-on-5 hockey to face off to the right of Brian Gillis. Phil Mangan finished his junior career with the St. John's Fog Devils. Redmen win the draw. The point shot does not make its way through. McAvoy, the final guy to block it. Boston stepped into the Centivac forward Swan, clear down ice. And an icing call against the X-Men. X-Men Hockey and Centivac Athletics would like to thank their major sponsors for their continued support. Keats, Pepsi, Bell Alliant, the Bridge and Grand Credit Union, Subway, Central Home Improvement, the Chronicle Herald, and Tim Hortons.
Swan with some pressure along the sideboards. Alex to make sure he gets it out of the zone and results in a icing infraction.
Brett Morrison trying to seal it back around the Centivac goal. That was cut off by the Redmen. Now they battle to the left of goaltender Brian Gillis. McGill trying to get one before this period comes to an end. Mangan up the near side to Morrison. He looks rink wide. He'll connect with Day, who has a goal in the hockey game. And Day now cycles back inside his own blue line for the X-Men. Being hounded there on the play by the McGill forward, Guillaume Doucette. Back on it is Mangan, slashed there by Boston. And Mangan able to hold him off as Morrison, I believe, has broken his skate blade. Here is Swan, and he got flattened. Got his head down, and McKiernan stepped into him. Here's Swan again, hit from behind by McKiernan. Swan is back up on his feet. The presence of mind to control the puck, hit a third time. And he'll get it back again, Bryce Swan. He turned it over this time. Boisvert trying to get inside the line, his weak shot. Off the end of the goal stick up Brian Gillis. The pace picks up as does the physical play as we near the completion of period one. Mark Lewis, big rugged defenseman for Centivac, able to break that play up. Loose puck in front of Gillis. McGill can't get the clear shot away. Here is a drive by Poirier, and he just missed short side. And it goes out of play, so the faceoff will be awarded outside the Centivac line, but good pressure. That shift, Paul, by McGill.
Swan was hit three times just inside the blue line, twice by number eight, Ryan McKiernan. And great pressure along the outside, some play in front of the net, and luckily for X, that puck hit the top of the boards and deflected over the glass.
Faceoff is outside the X-Men blue line. Jason Bass, Chris Shielded, and it's going to be Undershoot, the other forward for the Centivex X-Men. Kevin Undershoot. And again, a quick stoppage. Faceoff coming in the neutral zone. It'll be on the McGill side of center ice.
And Vero Paul and Picard Hooper, of course, mentioned earlier, number one and two in Canada. And Vero Paul with 26 goals already. I remember Dave Purcell scoring 40 1 year back in the late 80s, early 90s. I guess it was the late 80s. And I didn't think that was a number that would ever be approached.
Certainly Vero with an opportunity. Under a minute here to play in period one. Center backs get it outside the line, barely. Trying to force the play is going to be the Redmen. That's it, right. Trying to get it to the front of the goal. Picked up by Chris Hewlett. He'll saucer feed to Bass. Off the end of his stick, Kevin Undershoot. Steps in for the X-Men, trying to buy a little time. Pass is knocked down by a right. And he'll airmail one back inside the center back zone. Peugeot with a backhand feed to R.D. Chisholm. He'll catch up with it. He'll slingshot that puck up the wing. Now it is Bass in. Shot right on. Saved by Tardif. And Bass will follow up on his own rebound for the X-Men. To the point off the bench. McAvoy. Shot goes away wide. Center X with a little late pressure. Final seconds of the period. As it is centered off in front. And the buzzer will sound. As the X-Men start slow but finish strong. And a 3-1 lead, Paul, for the X-Men. After one period.
That's right. McGill started early, scored a goal at the 2:15 mark. A long play Poirier from Boisvert, and then it was three X goals. Dave from Mangan and Morrison at the 9:36 mark. The 11:29 mark, Eric McKenna from Claffey and McClellan, an even strength marker. And then at the 16-minute mark, Undershoot from McAvoy and Bast, a power play goal, is all our scoring in the first period.
Well, I think if you're Brad Peddle, you don't want to get too excited. It is exhibition hockey, but this team looked pretty good out there after finding their feet 5 or 6 minutes into that first period.
Yeah, and they moved the puck well, and like you say, they took them a few minutes to get ready, but once they did, they were ready to go, and they definitely can play with McGill.
3-1 is the score. The X-Men, after one period, lead the McGill Redmen. Don't go away. We'll be back with the period number two. It is the Keating Cup from the Millennium Center in Antigonish. Welcome back here to the Keating Cup. Ken McNeil along with Paul McDonald as we get you set up for period two. The X-Men with a 3-1 lead after one period. Yes, the X-Men will send Brendan Ray, Matt Bragg, and Scott Brandon up front. With Mark Lewis and Jason Day on the back end. Day with a goal in the hockey game here tonight. Center backs in their home white jerseys. The visiting team, the McGill Redmen, wearing their road red with the white trim. As Picard to Vero, his shot over top of the net. It will sail out of play, and we'll get a quick stoppage here, just 25 seconds into period number two.
Yeah, McGill opened the scoring early in the first at the 2:15 mark, and then three goals by Saint of X gave them a 3-1 lead. And they outshot McGill 12-8 in the first period of play with 25 seconds gone here in the second period of
McGill with a shot that's kicked out by Brian Gillis, the X-Men goaltender. Hubert Genet will hold foot at the left blue line and keep that puck in momentarily. Center back's trying to work it out. McGill will hold it in. Genet on the left blue line looking in, and it's dumped off. Center off in front. Loose man in front. That's Dorion, the defenseman. He quickly jumps up. Rebound! Stopped on the crease. They battle and jam away. Head pile up. Everybody in other than the two defensemen. And the referee, Hulshoff, there to shake his head to say, no, sir, as we get some pushing and shoving. As Ray gets it mixed up with Vero. He's certainly no stranger, Vero, to that part of the hockey game.
Dorion jumped in off the right side, in behind, and had a good scoring chance, and that puck was just sitting there. And if there was just a little bit of water on the ice, perhaps stopped that one from going in. But see a couple penalties being called by Hulshoff. Not sure what is going to be the call. It looks, from up here, can he? I don't know how Gillis covered that one.
I'm sure he had a little bit of help.
Yeah, it's, luckily for X that penalty shot's not called.
So the faceoff is going to happen inside the center of X line to the left of Brian Gillis. Looks like both sides will remain at five aside, offsetting minor penalties called. To the X-Men, Matt Bragg. He will sit in the penalty box. Can't see who's in the box for the McGill Redmen. Kevin Undershoot is on the ice with Chris Hewlett. And Jason Bass, that's your combination up front. And on the blue line is going to be Shane Donovan. And he'll play with number 24, Nick Pagiot.
Penalty
to center back number 45, Matthew Bragg. So 5-on-5 hockey in the middle period, as Donovan is rubbed out there by Boston. McGill with the puck at their own blue line. Valenti, rink wide to McKiernan, deflected across. Here's Marcotte over the X blue line. Up with a shot right on. And Gillis, they save, and he's going to hang on to the loose puck. That will set up a faceoff inside the center back's blue line.
Sean Donovan jumped in and kind of pinched in the center zone, took his man out. However, that reacted in the 2-on-1. But Chris Hewlett came back, did a good job to make it a 2-on-2 situation, and took the McGill player into the net, allowing Brian Gillis all the opportunity in the world to see that shot and make the save.
Nice job by Bass to win that faceoff. Undershoot trying to spring. The set of X forward, Bass, picked off by McKiernan. He's in quickly with a shot from a sharp angle. He whistled it wide of the goal. Picked up by Valenti. He sends it across ice, where Guillaume Doucette will control it now for McGill. Doucette with his head up. One backhand feed knocked down by Jason Bass. Played off there to Kevin Undershoot, and again a stoppage in play as a result. Glove to head pass, I believe.
Well, there's no doubt that the a little bit more intensity now between the two teams. At 26 seconds when we got the penalties, there was some good pushing and shoving in front of Brian Gillis. So although they probably liked each other to start the game, they're starting to dislike each other a little bit as the game goes on.
No question about that, as we see Boisvert and Swan rub shoulders as they wait the drop of the puck outside the McGill blue line. Mangan and Brett Morrison, the other two set of X forwards accompanying Bryce Swan, who will patrol the right side. DuPont couldn't play it out. Here is Boisvert with a backhand. McAvoy had jumped in for the X-Men. And it's going to be the puck to center. And here is Poirier, the goal scorer. Right side up with a shot. And that is over top of the net. McGill holding it in, deflected by Boisvert just wide as Gillis had started across the net. McGill trailing 3-1 in the hockey game. DuPont, the former Victoriaville Tigre defenseman, waiting for the puck at the blue line. 5-on-5 here with 17:40 to play. Here is a loose puck picked up by Brett Morrison. Morrison waiting for his mates to catch up, and he will slash the puck in. And McGill back on it, but the McGill defenseman Dorian broke his stick, was unable to play it. Here's a loose puck in front. They center it off. McKenna trying to feed Phil Mangan. The pass was too far for him. Picked up by Poirier as McGill sprint across their blue line. Poirier will dump that in as he takes a hit from Eric McKenna. Exer back. Pageau, the defenseman, moves it for McAvoy up on the right wing side. Played in over the line. McKenna not able to reach the puck as Vincent Bourgeois goes back to play. He had to contend with that broken stick. McGill to center ice. It is right to dump that in. There to play the puck is Picard. He takes the hit on the wall, right, trying to follow up on the play for McGill. Puck is going to be held in by the Redmen. Into right, can't reach it. Lost his stick. Set of X trying to hack it out. Held in by McGill. A little bit of pressure here. Give and go. Good shot. Better save by Gillis, the goaltender for Set of X. X-Men hemmed inside their blue line. Into right, trying to center it. Nice play by Gillis. Now he's down on all fours, trying to survey the situation. Right again. Hounded and hooked on the play. And finally, Warner took him down. And Hulshoff, with his arm in the air, will call a penalty against the Cinevex X-Men. McGill to their third power play.
Well, we saw great examples of their speed there. The play was kept alive a couple of times along the far sideboard. Ben Morse was able to come in and just nudge it ahead. And the good speed has caused Rob Warner to draw a penalty. He'll sit in the box for at least, well, 2 minutes or less, depending if McGill's finally able to break the goose egg on the power play.
Centivex trying to come up with the puck off the faceoff. They do, and it is cleared out by the Centivex defenseman. That is Jason Day. McGill back inside their own blue line, quickly trying to bring it up ice. Vossen will reach behind him and catch it. He'll circle inside the line again as McGill will set it up. Benjamin Morse will drop the puck there for his defense partner, Ryan McKiernan. Centivex with Bragg up front. Jason Bast off the bench to join him. McAvoy to in the backhand for the X-Men. Vossen moving down the far side, drops it off in the corner to Marcotte. He'll circle now behind the net, played up on the point in the near side. That is broken up, and here's a possible 2-on-1. It is a 2-on-1. Bragg right side looking, waiting, across, and the pass just behind a wide-open Bass, and sprinting back the other way in the counterattack, Marcotte. Marcotte held to the outside by Donovan, centered it, and it's cleared there by Claffey. X cannot move it outside the zone. In front it comes as the Redmen look to center. That is off the stick of Poirier. Poirier with the only goal for McGill so far. Right, feeding that puck to Ryan McKiernan. Power play for the Redmen. That fails to work. And the puck is picked up. Played up, but not out. Held in by the Redmen. Picard now will man the blue line on the far right point. Looks in front. Soft shot. Knocked down. Gillis now with a save. Paul looking for the rebound. And jumping on the loose puck, Brian Gillis to the X-Men. He's going to hang on to it. 3-1 X-Men lead.
X-Men a good chance to clear that puck, especially with McGill changing their lineup. While they had pressure in the Santa Fe zone, but they weren't able to get the puck out, and a good scoring chance resulted because of the fact that X tried to rush the play a little bit. 32 seconds left here in the McGill power play.
Face off again to the right of the Santa Fe starting goaltender, Brian Gillis. 13 shots, 12 stops. Off the puck drop, and it's going to skip outside the X blue line, so that will relieve the pressure here momentarily. McGill trying to get it up ice quickly. Picard nudges it ahead to Vero. Picard cuts to the goal. Vero will slow things down, sends it across that far point. Dorian waiting. He'll play it back in. Picard turning the forehand across to Vero. One-time shot went wide. He looked to set him up. Circle to circle pass. McGill controlling. Good defensive play there by the X-Men. That was McAvoy, I believe, down to block that pass. Penalty has expired. Another shot by Vero goes wide, keeping it in. Dorian, he steps up. Dorian, nice move to the back end. Shot wide, rebound in front. Gillis down, and he makes another good stop. And then we get some pushing and shoving to the left of the Cinevex net. And as Paul mentioned, these teams starting to develop a bit of a dislike for one another.
Nick Pageot being led to the box as he and one of the McGill players just at the side of the net after two great saves by Brian Gillis. Shot 7-0 here in the second period in favor of McGill. So he'll sit for 2 minutes, and of course going along with him is Alexander Picard. So it is roughing calls against each player.
Well, the Redmen with the advantage as far as the shot clock is concerned. 15-12. Now the X-Men will go to a power play. They're first to the second period. Or they will not go to a power play, excuse me. It'll be five aside. Kevin Hunter shoot up with a puck. He'll nudge it ahead to Swan. A little bit of speed and room. Shot scores! Nice, Swan! Wires that to the top corner on the short side. And it's 4-1 X-Men. You can see the gap from up top here as Tariff went down early.
Well, there's no doubt about it. If you watch goaltenders in the Quebec League, they play that butterfly style, but you have to stand up a little bit longer than that. You just cannot allow that to happen. A nice shot by Swan. There wasn't much room for that one to go, but that's what he's been doing in his years here at Cinevex. Bryce Swan, as he makes it a 4-1 lead for Cinevex, and really it was all McGill up until that point here in the second period.
Back to the big circle at center ice, and the X-Men extend their lead by 5-on-5 hockey. As Jason Day looking for his defense partner, Mark Lewis. Puck is out to the neutral zone. X trying to come up with it. Mangan overskates it. And it's Mark Lewis again for Jason Day. Up off the right side. Too far for Swan. That'll go for icing against the Cinevex. 13:39 here to go in the second period. Swan the goal scorer, and so he buries it top shelf, coming in off that right side.
An undershoot picked up the only assist on the play, and I'm sure if you're tired, if you'd like to have that shot back.
Face off again to the left of the ex-goaltender, Brian Gillis, who has been strong in this second period. That puck is sent sailing out of play again by the defenseman Benjamin Morse off the Redmen.
But good pressure by Cinevex to get out there immediately. I believe number 45, Matthew Bragg, gets out and pressures the McGill defenseman just to try to get that one in deep.
Off the puck drop, Wavair trying to step up and play it towards the front of the net. Big collision there right at the blue line as Scott Brannon finishes his check on Vincent Bourgeois. That shot again wide off the right point by McGill. Bourgeois racing across to hold it in time. Wavair behind the net. McAvoy trying to contend with him. Again, McGill keeping in at the offensive blue line. 4-1 lead, Cinevex on top. Now the puck to center ice. Here is Scott Brannon. He'll follow up on it. Dropping for Bragg, but intercepted nicely by the McGill forward Poirier, who had come back nicely on the back check.
Three McGill players converged on Brannon as he tried to just make that little dump pass across. Good work by McGill to come back, but they iced the puck with 7:06 gone here in the second period. One shot for X in the second period. Bryce Swan, who has 11 regular season goals, scored for Cinevex.
Face off to the left of Tardif. 4-1 hockey game. McKenna, Warner, and McClellan up front. Here's McKenna to McClellan. Shot off the post. Nice setup. Bang, bang, play. And a little bit of help from his post. Tardif gets there.
That was a nice pass from out behind the net by McKenna. McClellan with the stick on the ice was able to redirect that one quickly.
Here's a feed up for Vossen, the captain of the Redmen. He'll dial it in behind the Cinevex goal. He's taken to the ice. It's flipped up the wing by Claffey. Held in by the Redmen. Cinevex trying to get a favorable bounce. In front, that shot by Doucette. Kicked out by Brian Gillis. He looks sharp here and has got it covered at all angles here tonight so far. 12 minutes here to play in the second period. 4-1 X-Men as that puck is sent out by Cinevex. Marc-Andre Dorion. Little shoulder shake at center ice. Played ahead to Andrew Wright. He turned the puck over. Now it's sent up to McKenna. McKenna is rubbed out on the play there, and then he runs into the McGill defenseman, Kevin DuPont. Delayed penalty coming on the play, and it is going to Eric McKenna and the X-Men, or who's it going to? Paradif thought the first initially it was going to McGill, then he was a little unsure of himself. Marty McClellan over to have a word with him. Marc-Andre Dorion to check in as well. Those two guys, a couple of former Quebec League players, have, I'm sure, faced off against one another.
Well, McKenna with 2 minutes in the box, the retaliation to the hit along the boards. He was stood up just in front of his own bench, made a little push after the hit, and that's the call.
Hockey certainly a game of emotions, and you've got to be able to keep them in check. X-Men shorthanded, Chris Hewlett, saucer feet across. It never did reach Jason Bass on the play. Bass out of the way, that hit from Fences, Vero Paul. McGill to the power play again, trying to cut the lead in half, looking for a spark here. Dorion, the defenseman, nudging that puck in. Back to get it, Mark Lewis. He's beaten to the puck by Picard Hooper, the Redmen. Dorion keeps it in momentarily, but it's played up by Jason Day.
Day's got to get that puck deep. McGill, free chance to get it down. You can't make that little quick pass out.
McGill spread it out, Vero to Dorion. Back it comes to Dorion. He looks, sends it down low again. Picard. Try to feed it to the right. Broken up by the X-Men. Vero Paul behind the net. Centering high slot. And Doucette headed hop over his stick. And the puck is back to center ice. The X-Men halfway through the penalty kill. Here's a pass. Intercepted. Hilden trying to stride in. He looks. Fires. Big save and a rebound. Went right by the stick of Phil Mangan. And a penalty coming here against McGill. Hilden did a nice job to get away from the check. Got a good opportunity away as well.
Picard will pick up 2 minutes for hooking. As a good scoring chance there by Brandon, but a good save by Turdiff with Phil Mangan looking for the rebound. So we'll play 5-4 side for 54 seconds, and then it'll be a 1:06 power play for Santa Fe.
Face off to the right of Turdiff. Mangan will step in and win the draw for Santa Fe. Sean Donovan will deliver it behind the Redmen goal. Kevin Undershoot trying to come up with it. He's angled off nicely there by Hubert Genet, former Quebec Rampart defenseman. Battling for the puck, the X-Men and the Redmen. And it's going to be the home team, the X-Men, who come up with it. Now the puck will bounce back to center ice. Snapped in off the stick of Donovan, the center X defenseman. Midway point of period number two, the X-Men with a 4-1 lead. 16-13 are the shots on goal. One game showdown here for the Keating Cup. Last night's game postponed. Down the left side, Kevin Undershoot. He'll get it across for Mangan. He couldn't handle a bouncing puck. And it is going to be handled now by McGill. That's Bourgeois. He is the puck carrier for McGill. Up off that right side, nudged ahead by Marcotte. He tries to use that reach to his advantage. Centering pass. And the puck is going to be held inside the line by McGill. No, it's not. They'll have to evacuate. They do. And here comes Santa Fe. Claffey. Ahead it goes to Scott Brandon, to Swan. Back to Brandon. And he is watched closely there by Valentin. Valentin up the wing, but it's going to be held in by Claffey. It's a power play here now for the X-Men. Man advantage. Trying to hold it in. McAvoy. And it's flipped down ice by the McGill Redmen. X up 4-1. 9 minutes here to play in period two. Bryce Swan with a goal in this second period. Back on side are the X-Men, and McGill will take advantage and rag a little more time off the clock. Picked up by Valentin, and he is going to dump the disc down ice for the McGill Redmen.
Valentin did a good job on a 2-on-2 to come across and disrupt the pass for X. Then they get control and was easily able to get the puck down the ice.
Big 6'4" defenseman lumbering in, Mark Lewis. He gets knocked down, he gets back up again. And the Redmen are able to clear that puck down ice.
Back to 5-a-side now after the 1:06 power play. X unable to score on.
Scott Brandon trying to hook up there with Matt Bragg. He couldn't reach it. Vero Paul down the left side. And they're going to call that on the offside, I believe, against McGill with 8:18 here to play in period two.
Well, it was a 2-on-1 situation. Don't forget now with X in the second period are far away, the defense are far away from their bench on the change. And that 2-on-1 for McGill just offside with Verlo Paul trying to hit a streaking Picard Hooper going down through the center zone.
St. of X win that faceoff just outside their blue line. Big hit there as the St. of X defenseman, Andy Chisholm, was taken out by a couple of Redmen players. Verlo Paul trying to get it inside that scoring area as he rubs with Scott Brannan. Picard to hold it in. Now it's outside the line. Matt Bragg trying to nudge it ahead for Scott Brannan. Into right, spun around there by Brennan Ray. The X-Men are back to collect the puck. Looking up ice is Pageau through the middle. Bragg had a stick lifted. And an icing call coming here against the St. of X X-Men. A little chippier here in this second period.
That's a tough play. You know, you're up by 3 goals. You're coming out of your own zone. And it was a 10% perhaps chance that that pass was going to make it. Now icing call takes it back in your own zone with 7:44 left here and a 4-1 X lead in the second period.
Face-off is going to happen inside the X line. It'll be to the blocker side of Brian Gillis. Warner for the X-Men against Poirier for the Redmen. There's a drive. That shot does not find its way to the set of X net. It's going to be played ahead. Nice job there by DuPont to run a little bit of interference against the set of X attacker. Here is Eric McKenna with a goal in the hockey game. Gets it in over the blue line. Checked on the play by DuPont. They've had a little bit going here tonight, DuPont and McKenna. Murdoch, McClellan, Warner round out the center of X combination up front. That puck is flipped to the line, held in nicely by Rob Warner. Now it's outside the line. Murdoch, McClellan, and DuPont collide, the Redmen defenseman. Now Shane Donovan. Sean Donovan, that is. The center, and Poirier will take possession. And he will lift a backhander inside the center of X line. A wholesale change now for the Redmen. Hubert Genet sends that puck ahead. And now that is broken up by the X-Men as Conacher was looking for a one-timer. Puck back to center ice. Hubert Genet will handle things. Now to the Redmen forward. Biniak. And it's cleared in and down ice by the X-Men. And that will be an icing with 6:32 here to play in this second period. The X-Men up by a score of 4-1 as Biniak sees this, I believe, first shift for the hockey game.
Yes, definitely. You know, he's a rookie with this McGill team, and they've got a nice young team. Only 3 players in their fourth year. Nobody in their 5th year of eligibility.
That shot does not find the target. Mark Lewis, a little bit of help, clears it down ice. A foot race to it. Jason Bass, first man out, dropping for under. Shoot in front. That is blocked by the Redmen defenseman, Hubert Genet. Now it's going to be Vossen. He's in full flight, left side. Looking, firing, and a stop by Gillis as he hugs that post in the near side. Loose puck is gobbled up by the X-Men. Here's Swan across the center. Down the right side, looking, firing right on, and Tardif will stop that one. And Swan looking for a little repeat of his goal in the second period.
Well, that's only the second shot here in the second period by St. of X. We played 14 minutes and 2 seconds. Both shots, obviously, by Bryce Swan.
Face off will be to the left of Tardif. St. of X X-Men will see action again on home ice in the regular season next weekend, the 7th and 8th, as the Moncton Blue Eagles and the St. Thomas Tommies will be in town for a weekend tilt. And boy, second half of hockey, very important here in the AUS.
Val added a sniper, and I'm hearing rumors that Moncton added a few players as well, so it could be very entertaining second half.
Certainly a bad weekend. You can find yourself in a tight playoff race, that's for sure. As the X-Men come up with a puck, Bryce Swan with a lead pass. Sent off the right side to Pageau, the defenseman. He worked it ahead there. Trying to hook up on the play with Brett Morrison. Tardif is out of the goal to Ryan McKiernan. Cut off there by the center of X forward. That is number 77, Phil Mangan. McGill in with a chance. McKiernan, the defenseman, jumps up. Brian Gillis steps off in front as Vero Paul goes to the front of the net. And again, some pushing and shoving inside the X-Men blue line.
McAvoy wanting to get Vero Paul out of there immediately, but Paul just was trying to get out of there. He didn't want too much to do at that point. 5:05 left here in the second period. Faceoff deep in the Saint-Evex zone to the left of goaltender Brian Gillis, who's been perfect here in the second period, 10 for 10 on shots.
McAvoy will spin away from the traffic, the feed. Brendan Ray, and now ahead to Scott Brandon as he'll move it down the left wing side. They chop at it to the X-Men. Norion, the defenseman for McGill, able to get it to the near corner, and it's going to be back to center ice, McAvoy for Saint-Evex. Played in by the X-Men, Norion again, back, centered it off in front of his own goal. Bragg unexpectedly found the puck. Here's Ray with a drive, right on. Good stop that time by Tartup. This X-Men Hockey webcast is brought to you by the X-Varsity Club. Join the teams behind the teams. The X-Varsity Club is the fundraising entity for the Saint-Evex Athletic Program. Your financial support is essential to our success in maintaining the tradition of excellence. Visit www.goxgo.ca to learn more about the X-Varsity Club or join today. Saint-Evex, a weak shot, steered aside by Tardif. McKenna on the rebound. He centered McCullen drive. That is blocked off in front. They battle again for the puck. And it'll roll to the Redmen. A heavy slash there by McKenna. And he's got the hat trick as far as penalties here tonight. That'll be his third trip to the penalty box. And that was a no-doubter as well. Left a little doubt in the mind of the referee, Mark Holshop.
It's so, Eric, as you just mentioned, this third time to the penalty box, just missed a great chance there. Nice pass out in front to Warner, but coming across up through the center zone, a little bit too overexcited with the stick. And he slashed one of the McGill players. So McGill once again going to yet another power play here in the second period.
Well, the penalty kill has been solid here tonight for Brad Peddle and his X-Wing. Peddle in his sixth season behind the bench. Couple of guys assist him that certainly have played some hockey at elite levels in Norm Batherson and Dave Stewart.
That's right, and definitely they bring a lot of experience, especially penalty kills, power plays, to this team. And it's just Dave has been a great addition to the coaching staff here to compliment Brad and, of course, Norm Batherson. And one can't go too far without mentioning the addition of John Landry this year as one of the trainers.
Power play here for McGill. The X-Men lead the hockey game 4-1. Trailed early in the first period, but have reeled off four unanswered goals and haven't looked back since. Dorian will handle the puck for the Redmen behind the goaltender Tardif. And here come McGill looking for some type of spark across center ice. Do set to flip that puck in. Charging back to pick it up, Peugeot. He had lost control of it. As the Redmen looking for an option. Back to Dorion, center point. He'll look to the goal. Shooting lane, taken away. And McGill will remain patient on this power play. Vero taking the shot down low to right. Right back up top to Vero. He has a look across to Dorion. He'll one-hand that off. Dorion to Doucet. He was checked closely by Bass. And the X-Men trying to come back on an odd man rush. Peugeot to Warner. Good back check by Guillaume Doucet. Rebound. Sent over top of the goal. Warner trying to get it off on the short side. And tear it up there with a little bit of help from the Redmen blue liner.
Yeah, Doucet with a great play to come back on that 3-on-2 odd man rush to take the scoring chance away from X.
Vero with a slick feed to Picard. Up with a shot. Gillis didn't see it at all. Fortunately for the X goaltender, the shot didn't find the target. Held in by Ryan McKiernan. Played back in now is McGill. McKiernan. Off on that left wing side to Vero Paul. Still on the ice, McKiernan waiting, shooting. That gets blocked off in front and chopped out by the Saint-Evex X-Men. Puck is fed ahead to Morse as he jumps up on the play. Penalty set to expire here for the X-Men. And Saint-Evex get that puck out. Eric McKenna wanted to jump out of the box early. He would have found himself right back in if he had a... 2 minutes and 5 seconds here to go on the clock in the second period. Just the lone goal scored off the stick of Bryce Swan. Here is Poirier with a shot. That is checked there by the goaltender Gillis. And the X-Men flip the puck back out to center ice. Benjamin Moore sending it here in the near side. Played in by Beniak. Lewis getting back on it. Takes the hit from Poirier. And it's McAvoy Yes, he will dump that puck high over everyone and inside the McGill blue line. Mangan can't track it down. Beniak is hit by Swan. Kevin DuPont, the defenseman, is up. Slashing at the puck day, the Centivex blue liner. Brett Morrison trying to come up with it for Centivex. Morrison now will find some skating room up to the big defenseman, Lewis, across center. That play is going to be offside as Swan gets in ahead of the play. And that'll stop the clock with a buck 19 here to go in the second period. X leading 4-1.
Good play once again by the McGill defense to stand up at the blue line on that 2-on-2. Pushes the X players offside. And this is always a good play if you can challenge at the blue line.
Face off outside the Redmen blue line. Dave trying to reach it right at the McGill blue line. Played up and out by the Redmen. Scott Brennan trying to find the loose puck in between the blue lines. Now we'll back it up for Artie Chisholm. Back onto the stick of Brandon. Nice little move by Boisvert, and he's in over the McGill line. Yeah, that right side. Trying to turn that corner. Held nicely to the outside by Valenti. Valenti will back it up behind the net. Vincent Bourgeois, the former Montreal junior, back in to pick up the puck. Up the left side for Boisvert. Yes, he will hike it off the wall. Picked up by Boisvert. Under a minute here to go in the middle period. Artie Chisholm trying to knock that down out of midair. A backhand feed angled well off the back wall. And flipped back to center ice by Centivex. 4-1 hockey game, under 30 seconds here to play in the second period. Nick Pageau back to settle things down on the blue line for Centivex, but can't play it out. Vero Paul is in, and he was held to the outside. Centered it, and a good stop there by Brian Gillis off of Andrew Wright. And Picard gets dumped off in front of the net. And a penalty coming to the X-Men as Alexander Picard Hooper banged around in front of that net.
Looks like Brennan Ray going to the box as they were pushing the backs of Picard Hooper, and he went down, an easy call by referee Holshoff.
So with power play to end the second period for the Redmen, trying to cut this lead in half. 20-17, the shots on goal in favor of McGill, but it's the X-Men with the only goal of the period. Oh, Dorion not able to keep that puck in. He would have had a shot to the net. Puck back to center ice. And that will do it here for this second period as the X-Men outscore the Redmen 1-0 in the second period. And with that result, it is Centivex leading after 2 by a score of 4-1.
Well, you know, Centivex really weathered the storm there in the second period. Bryce Swan at the 6:02 mark with X's only first shot of the period. They didn't get another one until about the 15-minute mark of the second period. Undershoot picked up the only helper on just a rocket of a shot up underneath the crossbar by Bryce Swan, who's been doing quite a bit of that in his years here at Centivex.
Now, certainly if you look for a turning point maybe in that period, Paul, it was the goaltending at Gillis and then the opportunity by Swan, and Centivex certainly took advantage.
Absolutely. I mean, 25 seconds in, there was a big melee in front of Brian Gillis. If that puck goes in the net, it's a 3-2 game. Different complexion to the game, for sure. But, you know, no goal, and X were able to weather the storm and then come back and get one of their own.
20 minutes here to play from the Millennium Center. The Keating Cup up for grabs. Centivex with a 4-1 lead after two periods. We're back with period number three. Welcome back here to the Keating Millennium Center. The Keating Cup up for grabs as we get you set for the third period. 4-1 Palm for Brad Peddle. I guess the one thing that his team doesn't want to do is play Kitty by the door.
No, that's right. I mean, an exhibition game and all, but, you know, you just got to keep at them and keep making some good passes, good decisions in your own zone. You might not want to forecheck two guys, three guys deep now with a three-goal lead, but you just want to kill the rest of this penalty. There was a minute and 50 seconds left in the penalty to Brennan Ray that he got at the end of the second period. But, you know, just keep going, and it'll be a successful game for Saint of X.
Well, as we mentioned a few times throughout this broadcast, it was supposed to be a two-game series. It's now down to a one-game series. Of course, the McGill Redmen will move on and play the UNB Varsity Reds tomorrow night. Power play existing here as they look to go cross crease in front. They score. The Redmen on a deflection in front. And now we've got some pushing and shoving and a major pileup in front of the Cinevex goaltender. And we've got tempers flaring as big number 25, Mark Lewis, with the helmet off and the gloves off. And I'm telling you, that's one guy I wouldn't want to have angry at me at 6'4", 225 plus pounds.
I'm not sure what happened. I was Picard Hooper just threw the puck in front of the net, went off Lewis's stick, and all of a sudden he buried one of the McGill players in the net. I'm not sure which one it was at all.
If I was a betting man, I would say number 18, Farrell Paul, was probably in the middle of it.
Well, I just see him getting up at the blue line now, and perhaps it was, but McGill scoring on the power play at the 42-second mark, a deflection on a cross-zone pass by Picard Hooper, I guess. But nonetheless, it's a 4-2 game now for Saint of X.
Well, and I believe McGill will continue on the power play, whether or not I see a Redmen player in the box, so it will be offsetting Miners. Perhaps Lewis an extra two. We'll wait until they figure it out before we try to figure it out.
Well, shots and goal in the second period, 12-5 for McGill. The only goal in the second at the 6:02 mark, Bryce Swan from Kevin Undershoot for Saint of X. So as we wait for the referee to figure out what is going to be called here, the extra two up on the board right now to Lewis. So golden opportunity here for McGill after scoring on the power play to come right back on the power play, try to get within one goal.
Well, it certainly makes it a hockey game right now with another power play opportunity for the McGill Redmen. It's a 4-2 game. 42 seconds is all that took for the Redmen to strike. Jason Bass, Chris Hewlett up front, McAvoy and Claffey on the back end here on this Cinevex penalty kill. First power play goal of the hockey game as Bass trying to break in shorthanded. One on three backhand shot goes just wide. Lewis picks up 4 minutes for roughing. Picard Hooper picks up the deuce for roughing. So it's a 4-2 hockey game and a 5-on-4 for the McGill Redmen trying to creep within one. Dorion, ahead it goes, down the right side, Andrew Wright looking across, wide open the shot, they score! Vero Paul buries it on the power play. Hey, we've got a hockey game now. It's 4-3. That lead trimmed to one.
And you can see why Vero Paul has scored 11 power play markers so far this season for McGill. 10 what? In the regular season, and we've seen that play all evening where they tried to get him on the far side for the one-timer. There he took control of it and made a quick little snapshot in behind Brian Gillis. So the McGill Redmen, with 2 goals and 34 seconds, have cut the lead to one.
Sean Donovan back. He'll play the puck there to Chisholm. He'll leave it now for Phil Mangan. He'll work it up the near side. Morrison can't pick it up. That shot off the stick of McKiernan sails wide of the net. Dorion, the defenseman, making it happen on the back end. It's a 4-3 hockey game now. Cinevex lead evaporating to just one. Morrison ahead to Swan. Swan will glide across center ice and snap that puck in off the framework. Knocked down in front by the McGill Redmen, and up they come. Conacher not able to reach it. Bryce Swan will circle the wagons and try to bring it in. Broken up, and the X-Men now control it. as Ernie Chisholm to Brett Morrison. Head up and in over the line. Swan not able to reach it in time. Jason Day is back on the blue line for St. Evex to Ernie Chisholm. Chisholm ahead now for Phil Mangan. Mangan looking. He is rubbed out on the play, and it is played back behind the McGill net. Jason Day waiting for that puck finally does arrive. Brett Morrison in front through the legs of Scott Brandon. Day with a shot kicked out by Tardif. Big rebounds. That's been the story all night for the Redmen goaltender. Ernie Chisholm in a foot race with Poirier. He'll staple him to the back wall. Nice move by Brendan Ray to get it ahead, but Frank can't trap it onto his stick plate. The pace has quickened here to start period number three in the Redmen. Those bus legs have disappeared, and they're back in this hockey game thanks to two back-to-back power play goals. Morse, oh, he's hit hard there by Scott Brannan. Now the pass sped up on the wing to Brannan. Trying to beat Gene. There's a backhand shot and a save made by Tardif, and the rebound will fall in his lap and he'll hang on to it. So a chance at the other end for the X-Men.
Well, Scott Brannan with a good burst of speed. It looked like Benjamin Morse was going to come up and play the puck, but he realized that the speed of Brannan was just too much. Bragg going hard to the net looking for the rebound, but Tardif was able to cover that one up with 3:06 gone here in the third period.
Faceoff to the right of Tardif, the goaltender this evening of record for the Redmen. Hilbert Genet will play it ahead for Picard onto the tape of Vero. He'll get it across center. Travels down the right wing. Little room outside, beats Claffey, trying to center it as Vero. Good speed. Just about cut back to the inside. X across the line, undershoot to Bass. Shot deflected wide as Hewlett made his way to the front of the goal. Picked up by McAvoy to Claffey. He shoots, and that is deflected wide of the net. Kevin Undershoot back on top of the puck. Fast in front. Hewlett off the post. Big bang, bang play again. And the second time the X-Men have hit the post. Kevin Undershoot. He's been dynamite tonight in front. McAvoy had jumped up, and he couldn't redirect the puck by Tardif. Here's a break for Picard. He's in, trying to catch up with it. McAvoy will seal him up on the back wall. And behind the play, we've got a couple of players tangled up.
I believe it's Hewlett for St. X. And I can't see a number here for...
A couple of big linesmen in on top of it as well. Brian McDonald and John McDonnell doing their best to break this up. And more penalties going to come as a result of that. Fracas right at the blue line, and... Who else but number 18, France, with Francis Veropaul.
It looks like offsetting roughing penalties, but a good scoring chance down the other end by McGill. And all of a sudden, the whistle blew all the way back up in the other zone. The extra two up on the board for McGill. So a chance now for St. Evex to at least give themselves a little bit of a cushion.
Well, as we've mentioned again throughout the broadcast, Francis Veropaul, that is something he did on a regular basis, a fan favorite and a real agitator in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League with the Chicoutimi Saguenay, playing under the guidance of Richard Martel, not a bad guy to get under your skin either. Face off inside the McGill line, Centivac's controlling the puck. Day will nudge it across for Pageau. Back to Day. Center point. It's a power play here for the X-Men. Trying to stop the McGill momentum. Day looking from the point. Faking off that far circle to Morrison. Back to Day. Day in the far side. Pageau shoots it as he was set up nicely in the one-timer. One defenseman will operate in this power play. In comes Morrison's shot. Save. Rebound. They score. Pageau gets it by Tardif. It's a power play goal. Heavy X-Men lead it 5-3.
I believe that's our fourth power play marker of the game, two for each team. But Pageau comes in off the far or the near point. And if he didn't put that one in, Bryce Swan had a good chance to put it in. But Pageau puts it in behind to give X that two-goal cushion. That came 30 seconds into the McGill penalty.
So the McGill momentum has been stopped. And the X-Men score their fifth of the hockey game. And have a two-goal cushion. With 4 minutes and 28 seconds gone in period number three. Since 2006, the Keating Cup has been up and played here at the Millennium Center. Center of X, defending champions each and every year. Here comes McGill. Poirier in front of the scramble, and the Redmen not able to reach back for that puck. As it slapped off the glass by the X-Men and down ice, that is going to be an icing call against Center of X.
If I'm not mistaken, the first couple seasons for the Keating Cup was a four-team tournament. And the last 2 years has gone just to two teams. It's kind of a challenge cup, as this one is the same. So it's good to get some good hockey going here over the holiday break.
Brady Chisholm back to guide the puck up the far side to McKenna. McKenna takes the check and makes the pass. Warner trying to reach it. But it is McGill will regain control. The puck Conacher is knocked down. Picking it up for Cinevex is going to be Claffey. Claffey watched by two Redmen, and then that puck gets into the center of X bench as they take cover. And a stoppage in play as a result. Well, the X-Men Hockey and center of X Athletics would like to thank their major sponsors for their continued support. Keats, Pepsi, Bell Alliant, the Virgin Grand Credit Union, Subway, Central Home Improvement, the Chronicle Herald, and Tim Hortons. Face off deep inside the center back's blue line. Mark Lewis is back onto the ice. Sean Donovan will get it ahead for Scott Brandon. He's across the red line and the puck is dumped in deep. Tardif coming out of the net. Ray trying to work off of his man. It is kicked out by the Redmen. And ahead it goes. As Lewis takes a shot at Biniak. And Mark Lewis, as I mentioned, just got back out of the box. Is going to step back into the penalty box, and another power play for the Redmen.
And that might have been just the result of being too tall, is Biniak probably 6 inches shorter than Lewis, takes one in the chops, an easy call by the referee. But now a good chance here for McGill. They've already had two power play markers here in the third after really not having much success at all in periods one and two on the power play.
To the front of the goal, that's in traffic, the puck in the blue paint, and Ryan Gillis will find it in the nick of time and freeze frame the play, and it sets up another offensive faceoff for the Redmen.
So McGill like to try to spring the far side winger, and again, once that guy gets the puck, he's able to try to hammer that one home. Of course, Ropal in the box with Chris Hewlett, as they have to serve at least 2 minutes.
The Redmen controlling. There's Dorio, shot, scores! As he sends it on goal, Brian Gillis perhaps screened. It rang off the post in the far side and got by the ex-goaltender. And once again, it's a one-goal lead. X on top, 5-4. And there is a perfect example of how important it is to get that puck on net. Certainly not a hard shot, but one that was accurate.
Well, Biniak in front of the net was able to tip that one inside the post area. So three power play goals in the third period by McGill. Once again, it's a one-goal lead for X. And, we've had four goals in the first 5 minutes, 44 seconds of this period.
So back to center we come for this face-off. Undershoot and Bast up front. They'll be joined by number 81, the pride of Mabu, Meredith McClellan. On the back end, Donovan and Claffey. McGill going after that puck inside the center back's line. Meredith McClellan reaching out for it. Not able to gain control of the puck, and it's going to be Claffey. Sends the puck ahead for Meredith McClellan. McClellan will hook up with Donovan. He overskates it, and Jason Bass will drop the puck now to Claffey. A center back's looking to get organized inside their own blue line. Here is Bass on the right side. McKernan took his man off the puck. It is nudged ahead, and here come the Redmen. Just getting out of the way of that hit was the Redmen forward, Boisvert. McGill inside their blue line. Down by one now. Trailed 4-1 at one point in the hockey game. Couple of goals in this period. And now it is a 5-4 hockey game and an icing call coming against the Redmen.
Biniak doesn't see a whole lot of ice time. Only played two regular season games so far for McGill. Tough lineup to crack, obviously. But he adds 2 points in those two games. And he went right to the net on the power play and was able to deflect that one home.
Face off to the left of Tardif, the goaltender. For the Redmen, Mangan will stride in and get set for this all-important face-off. for the X-Men. As he did a nice job to tie his man up and use his feet to kick it back. Center back sent it to the front. That is deflected. Turniff looked everywhere, including behind him, as Swan will squash his man on the far side. Brett Morrison trying to come up with it. Mangan will beat it in a little deeper. Morrison shoulder to shoulder with Boston. The puck comes free, and it's collected by Cinevex. Mangan down low to Brett Morrison, outstretching him. In front it comes, and it's going to be handled now by Blunden off the Redmen. Mangan will clear it in over the blue line as Swan and Blunden with a heavy collision. Here's McAvoy up in the rush, but he couldn't contain the puck.
Ken, McAvoy taking that. He's a right shot. If he was a left shot, that would have been a perfect pass. So just a bad luck there for X.
12:35 here to go in the third period. It is a 5-4 hockey game. Goals a little more freely in this third period. Shots 24-21. Set of X controlling. Mark Lewis looks rink wide. Off the skate of Scott Brandon. He hustles into the corner. Knocked down by Dorian X coming off in front. And not able to get the puck by Tardif would be Brennan Ray. Scott Brandon will deliver a good body check on that back wall. Cinevex in front. Matt Bragg couldn't find the handle. Here's Lewis at the point. Drives one on. Rebound. They whack away. Scott Brandon can't find the back of the net for Cinevex. Picked up and cleared down ice by the McGill Redmen. So both sides have opened it up, and that's provided some exciting hockey here in this third period for sure.
Well, both teams not afraid to get in front of the goaltender to provide some screens, and that makes it tough for both teams in the net.
McGill over the line. Here is Picard. Knocked that down, then centered. It's by everyone. And here comes center X across center ice. Two on one. Healed it left side. Waiting, shooting, and that is blocked. What a defensive play there by Hubert Genet. Lone man back. Here's a bouncing puck. Pajot found himself up, and two on one back the other way. McGill, Picard, Vero. They look to be out of gas. Yeah, the Redmen are going to hold control of the puck. Picked up behind the net. Vero trying to center. He gets knocked down. McGill. Vero. Loose puck. They score! As Beniak ties this hockey game at 5. And Beniak has taken advantage of every shift he has gotten in this hockey game. And all of a sudden, it is a 5-5 game.
That's the second goal here in the third period, our first even strength marker of the third period. A wide open net, and he's able to just inch that one over the line to make it a 5-5 game with the shots at 25-23. McGill with five shots here in the third period, scoring on four of them.
Well, another goal off a scramble in front of Brian Gillis. And Brad Peddle will look to McClellan, Warner, and McKenna up front with McAvoy and Artie Chisholm on the blue line. Here's a puck off in front, cleared away by the X-Men. Here are the Redmen. They've found their mojo here in this third period and have tied the hockey game. Poirier battles Warner, but Poirier wins the battle. He centers it, scrambling again in front, and Gillis swimming around in that crease, finds the puck, and will hang on to it.
Definitely using the speed to their advantage, and they're just crashing the net looking for rebounds. Gillis seemed to be left all alone there. It's one thing McGill has really shown me tonight. They have a lot of speed up front. 10:42 left here in the third period. Face-off will come to the left of goaltender Brian Gillis. 26-23 the shots in favor of McGill.
Now Cinevex gets set on this draw. It's Mangan, not able to win it this time, but picking up is Morrison as he'll turn it up through the middle. But he overskates the puck, and X will regroup back at their blue line. Jason Day looks cross ice, hooks up with Swan. He'll tap that in off the goal stick of Tardif. Traveling back to pick it up is going to be Ryan McKiernan. He'll take the hit from Morrison. Swan can't reach it, and it's back to the Cinevex side of center. Lewis quickly head to Mangan. That hit by Swan. And controlling the puck now is going to be the Redmen. Levesque to throttle that puck in. Picked up by Jason Day. Day will turn it and get it up quickly. Cuts it across for Phil Mangan, who was following up on the play. And then Mangan will rattle it in deep for the X-Men. 5-5 hockey game. As the puck rolls back to Pajot, the X-Men. to Brett Morrison. Morrison will connect to Mangan. He'll buy some time. Brandon off the bench, not able to reach it. And then he will run into Valentin, the McGill defenseman. Up it goes to Vossen. He is stripped of the puck. Scott Brandon, nice pass to Bragg, right side. Penalty coming to the Redmen. Bragg couldn't force it off in front. Alshoff will stop the play, and the X-Men are going to the power play. It's an interference penalty against McGill.
Morse jumps up. It was a 3-on-2. He just ran into Brandon to take him out of the play, and that's the reason that there is an interference call against McGill. So X with a chance now to regain the lead, as they've been outscored 4-1 here in this period, but their power play has been clicking. It's got, they have scored two power play goals.
Face off again to the left of Tardif. X to the power play. Murnik McClellan, Kevin Undershoot. 2 minutes for along with Jason Bass, they'll use Hewlett on the back end with McAvoy. And the puck is going to be cleared down ice by the McGill Redmen. The X-Men looking for a power play goal to take the lead again. Center of X circling inside their blue line, and up they come. Left wing side. Hewlett striding down the wing, stepped around a man, but then lost the puck. And the Brian Gillis will chase that puck down into the corner.
McGill like to challenge when St. of X are coming through the zone with the speed.
Here are the X-Men again. Spencer McAvoy will feed it across now for the X-Men. Now to the point, and Chris Hewlett not able to hold that puck in for St. of X. St. of X looking to activate perhaps. Threaded through the needle. Murdick McClellan tied up his man. No icing on the play. Tardif out of the net. He'll relay that puck around the wall. Bass will let it roll free. McClellan back to Jason Bass. Bass today looks off here to Chris Hewlett. He'll get to the forehand. Cross ice shot there. And Bass didn't get a whole lot on it. And the Redmen will ring it around the wall and down ice. 40 seconds to go in this St. of X power play.
I believe one of the McGill players, the forward, was able to get a stick in front of that quick shot. So definitely saved the goal.
Mangan to snap that into the right of the goaltender, Antoine Tardif. But the Redmen are back to grab possession and throw the puck down ice. Day is back for the X-Men. Time running out on this latest power play. Brett Morrison, he was stripped of the puck, a little nonchalant with it. Following up is Day, the defenseman. He tries to lift that puck in, and it's picked up and cleared down ice by the Redmen. And that is going to do it for the power play, as Morse, the defenseman, is back onto the ice. 7:30 here to play in the third period. Breakaway pass. Swan moves in. A dink as he gets hauled down from behind. He looks for a penalty shot immediately, but nothing from Holtschoff. Didn't get a shot away. And I guess you have to say a good defensive play with no penalty called in the play.
That's all the way the ref sees that one. Oftentimes you will see a call, but no call there.
Brett Morrison trying to dipsy doodle right at his own blue line. Mangan trying to come up with a puck. Now off the bench comes Scott Brandon. He has the puck. Brandon will cut it down the right side. Shot saved by Tardif. And he will hang on to the rebound in a 5-5 hockey game from the Millennium Center, the Keating Cup. 6:50 left in this third period.
Looked over the St. of X bench after the chance by Swan, and the referee, or Coach Peddle, just said the hands just turned up, saying, why isn't there a call? But referee decides not to, and Brendan Ray talking to the Holtschoff there now, asking why, and faceoff will just come to the left, so no call.
And the puck drops. St. of X winning the draw. Shooting it would be Bragg. That's knocked down in front now off. And it's cleared. Last second by the Redmen. Bragg will slice a backhander in, trying to follow up on the puck. And it's going to be McGill to center ice. St. of X will reclaim control. Donovan, the ex-blue liner, trying to get to that red line. Plays it ahead, but it's broken up. Picard can't play it. R.D. Chisholm ahead to Scott Brandon. Can't hook up with Brandon Ray. Into the corner, and the near side goes the puck. Slap to the far side. Scott Brandon. Fan on the shot, rolling puck, and it's freed up by the Redmen and cleared all the way down ice. That'll roll right the goaltender, Brian Gillis, no icing on the play. 6 minutes here to play in the third period. We're tied at 5, the Redmen and the X-Men, the AUS against the OUA. Puck is inside the Redmen line, flipped high through the air. Battling there, Mark Lewis used just about every part of his body to get that puck out. As Bass undershoot and Hewlett on the ice for the X-Men looking to score that all-important go-ahead goal. Here is Hewlett to drive that puck deep. Bass waiting for it. He gets hit before the puck got to him. And Mark Lewis is back on it. Now Chris Hewlett once again sends it across for Kevin Undershoot. He'll finally control it. Bass heading to the net. The puck there. And now it's pinched in behind the net. Chris Hewlett will turn it behind the net. Bass leaving it roll through to Kevin Undershoot. Undershoot gets taken down on the play. And all of a sudden, Mark Kulshoff has tucked that whistle away. Here are the X-Men on top of the puck. Here's Swan. Fire. Stick stop made by Tardif. Bass tied up neatly by the Redmen player behind the net. But Centivex will hold the puck inside the McGill blue line. 5-5 hockey game off the bench. For the Centivex X-Men comes number 10, Brett Morrison, but it's going to be an icing call against the McGill Redmen.
One thing about Bryce Swan, if he gets a chance to get that shot away, he usually does with something on it. And there, the puck was bouncing a bit. He got control and had that quick little snapshot down low. And Tardif had to make a nice save with that stick to keep this play knotted up at 5.
Face off to the left of Tardif. A tight 5-5 hockey game. X led 4-1 coming into period number 3. They quickly saw the Redmen score twice. Then X went up by 2 again. And then the Redmen back on the power play have made it a 5-5 game. The X-Men Hockey Webcast is coming to you live on SSN Canada, the streaming sports network. Visit the streaming sports network at www.ssncanada.ca. SSN, here's sports anywhere, anytime. Back to the action at ice level from the Millennium Center here in the campus of Centivex University. Levesque, right side, trying to get that ahead for Poirier. He'll deal it in behind the net. McGill coming up with it, looking to center. It gets high up in the air, knocked down by Swan. Swan ahead to Morrison. And that puck is cleared in by the X-Men. Tardif coming out of the net. We'll play it around the wall. Cut off as the X defense. That's Claffey. Now it's going to be the Redmen defenseman, Bourgeois. Center of X are back inside their own line. McGill trying to change on the fly. Bryce Swan tied up with a couple of Redmen players. Seven guys on the ice. You can hear Brad Peddle hollering to the referee, Hulshoff. X-Men coming up with it. Brendan Ray turned it over. Here's Andrew Wright back the other way for McGill. Wright with a shot. Blocked there by Claffey, the ex-defenseman. Vero Paul is hit by R.D. Chisholm. Chisholm trying to get the puck through the traffic. Andrew Wright for McGill. Giving a shove there. Now it's rattled up the near side. Scott Brandon does deliver the puck out after he takes a hit from Vero.
Both teams not wanting to get caught with too many guys deep with 3:10 left here in the third period. And here we see McGill really forcing X to make that first pass out.
Nice patience by Lewis. Gets it ahead to Bragg. He'll get across center. Bragg cuts down in off that left side. Scott Brandon will head to the bench on a line change. Under 3 here to play in the third period. We're tied at 5. Here's D. Shooting. Tardif. Thought he had it. Boy, a rather simple looking stop that he made awful difficult. Back to Day again. He winds and fires. Oh, that time. Tardif flashed the leather and made a good stop. This time, no rebound.
That's right. He was able to see this one in good concentration. The other one, he seemed to duck just as the puck was coming at him. And it rattled a little bit off his glove hand, which gave a good scoring chance to X. 2:42 left here in the third period. Face off deep in the McGill zone to the right of goaltender Antoine Tardif.
27-27. Shots on goal. That is dead even. 5-5 in the scoreboard. And with 2:40 here to play in the third period. Kevin Undershoot to Chris Hewlett. The captain now to Bass. Bass back to Hewlett. And he was watched very closely. Then the ex-forward Undershoot was knocked down. And the play stopped again as a result of a glove-to-head pass. Faceoff should come outside the McGill blue line.
Because of the glove pass from the Centivex player in the McGill zone. With 30 left in the third period. Undershoot passed. Hewlett out for X.
Off the draw, undershoot, sprints into Hewlett. Hewlett to Bass, and he was checked at the last second by Guillaume Doucette. Might have saved a goal there. Here's Hubert Genet trying to bring it up the wall, blocked by the X-Men. Now it is blocked and sent out by the McGill Redmen. 2:10 here to play in the third period. X are trying to bring it and get the go-ahead goal. Icing a call now against St. of X with 2:06 to play in period three.
Durian just jumped up at the blue line and was able to interfere just enough with the St. of X player for that puck to go down for an icing infraction. And when you're standing still on the other side of the red line, more often than not, an icing infraction could occur, and that hopefully will not come back to haunt St. of X here with 2:06 left in the third.
Ryan Gillis hasn't seen a whole lot of action as of late. It seems that the Redmen, since they have tied it, are happy enough to force overtime or a shootout or whatever may lie ahead. We're not sure either. 16-0-2 in the season are the Redmen. Both losses coming in a shootout. Here is Peugeot. Rolling puck finally settles it. Back to Peugeot with a high drifting shot. That looked like it was hitting to the top shelf, but it deflected off of something in front and out of play.
I'm not sure what that deflected off. Was it Tardif or one of the X players? Faceoffs coming inside, so obviously it was off one of the McGill players with 1:42 left here in the third. Mangan out to take this faceoff for X.
Well, Mangan has been pretty solid in that faceoff circle tonight. Chalk up another one for the veteran centerman. X with pressure. That puck has worked to the far corner. Behind the net is going to be picked up by Brett Morrison as he loves to stick handle with the puck to Mangan. Looking to turn away from Bourgeois. Peugeot at the near point. Faking, trying to slap pass for Morrison on a deflection. Right idea, just failed to work. X continue to apply the heat, but it is cleared out. Picard trying to get it up in a hurry. He had Vero with him. But a good defensive play by the X-Men.
That's definitely two guys you don't want coming down the 2-on-1 late in the hockey game, but Picard blew a tire just at the blue line and fell down.
Here's Matt Bragg to get it in over the line. Under a minute here to go in this third period. We're tied at 5, and with the Keating Cup up for grabs, I'm guessing there's got to be a winner leaving the building tonight. Here's Zuppero Paul. Good stop there by Brian Gillis. Yes, he robs Vero Paul with perhaps a game saver. Not perhaps. Here's Bragg across. Deflected there by Lewis. That was close to offside on the play.
Very close to offside, but X able to stay just onside.
McAvoy across to Lewis. He'll string it out. Oh, that pass is intercepted. Here's McKinnon, the defenseman. He'll race down the left side. Up shooting, and a stop made by Gillis as they open it up. End-to-end action here with 20.3 seconds to go in this third period in a 5-5 hockey game.
McKinnon with a good burst of speed off the far side. 12 points in 18 regular season games for McGill. So he can't find the back of that net, and Gillis with a good shoulder save.
Inside the X line, the puck is down. Undershoot battling for control. X want to get it out, but here is Poirier. To Boisvert, he's hit. To the point to Genet. Good shot blocked by the captain, Hewlett. Gillis with a stop. Dying seconds off this third period. And it will run out, and the Redmen with their best period of the hockey game, and it comes at a crucial time, and we have ourselves a 5-5 hockey game. And again, the format for us a little bit up in the air, but I'm guessing we may see, I would suggest, a 5-minute overtime.
It's going to be a 3-minute break and then a 10-minute sudden death overtime period.
Well, you heard it first right here on SSN. X and McGill are tied at 5. We'll take a break and we'll be back with overtime. The Keating Cup up for grabs. The Redmen battle back in period 3. But we're back and ready to go for overtime. It's a 10-minute sudden death, and it will be 4-on-4 hockey. So lots of room to navigate out there for sure.
Yeah, and of course McGill starts with a couple of their snipers up front. So if you're actually, you have to know exactly where Bro Paul and Picard are at all times.
I'd say you'll see both sides take some chances, and we'll see what happens here in overtime from the Millennium Center in Antigonish. Keating Cup on the line. Here's a feed for Mangan. He's got some room. In with a shot. Oh, Tardif. Well out the challenge and cut down that angle. He wasn't sure where that puck was, but it was caught up in his equipment as Phil Mangan blasts one towards the McGill goaltender. That could have ended real quickly. 28 seconds in fact.
Mangan tried to go short side. And he made a good decision as he tried to go short side blocker, but Tardif was able to make the adjustment and make the save.
Well, Tardif, after maybe a bit of a shaky start and a couple of goals, has certainly turned his game around here tonight. It's 5-5. Another loose puck at center ice. 4-on-4, sudden death overtime. And there'll be room to maneuver. Here is Guillaume Doucette, steps in and around that shot. Blocked up the stick of Sean Donovan. Ahead it goes through the middle to Morrison, and he gets his head up in the nick of time with big number 8, Ryan McKiernan, bearing down on him. Sean Donovan for the X-Men will play it up on the wing. Tapped in on a deflected pass by Morrison. X will change on the fly. Picking it up will be the McGill Redmen. Biniak feeds the puck in. He'll go chase it down himself as Claffey will rub him out in the back wall. Battling there is Andrew Wright as well, but here is the big captain, Chris Hewlett. Little slick toe drag. Stepped by one man, but will recircle back inside his own line to Claffey, the ex-defenseman. Played up in the wing to Bass. He goes rink wide. Hewlett will catch up with it. Chris Hewlett trying to step around the McGill to forward, not able to do so. And back come the Redmen as Vero Paul will bring it down that far wing, trying to cut off in front. Gillis made the stop, and here come the X-Men trying to work it in transition. Bass down that left side, late man is McAvoy shot, and he ripped it wide. And then Bragg ran into the goaltender, Antoine Tardif. Jason Day to hold that puck in on the left blue line. Rattles it around the end wall. Matt Bragg controlling it for the X-Men. Will feed it there to number 20, Bass. Bass back to Bragg. Bragg on the left point to Lewis. Shot sails wide of net. Picked up again by Bass. Bass to Matt Bragg. Bragg will dump the puck deep. Bass will head to the bench on a line change. 7:40 here to play in overtime in a 5-5 hockey game. On that left side, it's Dory on the defenseman. He'll try to split the two center back players. Vero Paul shot right on. Saved by Brian Gillis. As he took that maybe between the eyes. Picked up by Day. Oh, he was stripped. Last man back. Vero for the Redmen with the Picard going to the front of that. But Cinevex able to get back in time to break up that latest scoring attempt by the Redmen. Puck is cleared out by the X-Men. Matt Bragg has been out a long time. Finally does make his way to the bench. 3 minutes gone here in overtime. We're tied at 5.
Picard with a nice move to keep that play alive. But they didn't have a whole lot of speed, so X were able to get the puck out of the zone.
Up that right side for Murcutt. Speed and room. He looked to cut to the middle of the ice. Paggio took it away from him. Now Ray will send away Murdick McClellan. McClellan breaks down the right side to the front of the goal. Ray cutting hard. And the puck never did get to him in time. Back the other way now as they open it up here in overtime. Ryan McKiernan is back to play the puck for the McGill Redmen. As McGill slowly bring it through the middle of the ice, ahead it goes. Murcutt fell down. The loose puck at the X blue line. Murdick McClellan to Nick Pageau. Pageau will try to break in. Nice move around. 1 minute shot. And it just sailed wide of the net. Off the bench comes Mangan, but that is intercepted. Possible 2-on-1 McGill. As Valentin had trouble handling that rolling puck. Will settle it now. Shooting from a sharp angle. Saved by Gillis. And it's R.D. Chisholm.
And Mangan with some nice work there. Chisholm picked it up. He was going to rattle it off the boards, but Mangan was yelling, time, time, time. So good, smart play.
That's certainly great communication as well. And nice head fake by Mangan. Steps up, steps in, steps around. He looks to center. Nothing but red jerseys in his way. And it's McGill back the other way. Bringing it in over the line is going to be Barbera in front. Boston's shot goes wide. Dorion, the defenseman, he's up, stepped around Donovan. And a good defensive play there by McAvoy. But Dorion finds the puck back on his stick again. 5:25 left in overtime. Loose puck to Swan. Now he'll leave it. McAvoy intercepted. Here's Dorion. Right side, stepped around. In shot. Oh, what a stop by Gillis as he robs Dorion, the defenseman, with a nifty move. But a better stop by Gillis, the goaltender for Cenevex.
What a read by Dorion to pick that pass up and go in all alone. As he read that pass from the X zone, picked it up, went in, went around the defenseman, but he was stoned there by a great save by Brian Gillis.
Well, great vision and anticipation by Dorion. Not only good defensively, but he can do it at the other end. Here comes McGill again. They have had the better chances as Wright goes harder than that, trying to force that puck behind Gillis, the goaltender. 4:41 now to play in overtime. We remain tied at 5.
4-1 the shots here in the overtime period in favor of the McGill Redmen. The best chance, obviously, that one that just occurred by Marc-Andre Dorion.
Or as they like to say in Pumpkin, Dwyron.
It's been hard not saying that tonight, let me tell you.
Face off to the right of the goaltender, Brian Gillis, who has made 30 stops in the hockey game here tonight. Pete Carrot will turn it center, and he'll cut it in off that near side. Now to the middle of the ice. Pete Carrot looks up and will connect with Janae to the fence, but across and off his skate. Vero Paul get dumped, and Cenevex will bring it up. Day backs it up a bit. Brett Morrison will find time. Fires a shot off the left pad of the goaltender, Tardif. Huge, ginormous rebound. Given up again by Tardif. Picked up by Picard Hooper. Through the cresting at center. Knocked down by Claffey, the ex-defenseman. He'll back it up for Pangeon. Up at the ex-blue line for Chris Hewlett. Hewlett now leaving it for Claffey. Claffey in the far side to Bass. Now it's rink wide to Hewlett. He breaks in over the Redmen line. Hewlett cutting, shooting as he went down, was hauled down, and a penalty coming to the Redmen. Hewlett got a heck of a chance nonetheless as he was sliding down, and a penalty to McGill.
I'm going to tell you from here, it looked like he may have just lost the edge as he tried to jump back into the inside, and the defenseman McKiernan not too happy at all with the call. He perhaps got a little bit of the stick on it, but what a move by Hewlett as he tried to reverse it and take that quick shot. So X with a now a 4-on-3 for the next 2 minutes as they look to end this game in overtime.
And when you have a 5-on-4 power play, much different with a 4-on-3. It almost feels like a 5-on-3. It's hard to cover that extra man, and there's lots of room out there to move the puck, and you'll see a lot of lateral puck movement.
Absolutely. I mean, if you're X now, you'd want to get somebody open on the far side for that one-time shot, similar to the goal that Verol Paul scored in the third period at the 1:16 mark. So if you're X, you're really either that or loaded up at the point, look for the rebound. That was a tough one, though. I mean, McKiernan played that one pretty strongly, but a good, smart play by number 9, Chris Hewlett, to jump back in, reverse the play, and get a good scoring chance off.
So the X-Men on a power play here with 3:41 to play in overtime. A faceoff coming inside the McGill line. Brian Gillis with a couple of tremendous stops in overtime to get us to this point in the hockey game. Tardif will have to do the same for his team. X with a faceoff. McAvoy, Hewlett with undershoot to the front of that. Jason Bass, the other forward. He works off the fair circle. Download undershoot. Back up top circle to Bass. Now to McAvoy. The X-Men looking to be patient and trying to move it east and west. Here is McAvoy. Center point. Hewlett's one-timer. Didn't get a whole lot on it, but enough that it springs off the toe of the goaltender, Tardif. Hewlett again, faking to McAvoy. To Hewlett, shot right on. Nice anticipation by Tardif as he pushed up that fair post and got to the middle of the net in time.
You may want to move Hewlett down just a little bit deeper and try to get that same passing going and look to spring him like that, because Tardif had all kinds of time to read that pass, get across, and make the save.
3:09 to play in overtime. 1:29 left in the McGill penalty. And not only a costly one, but perhaps their best penalty killer on the back end in Ryan McKiernan. It certainly logs a lot of ice time. Pageau now, and Mangan will handle the point. Here is Pageau. That was in his skates, that pass from Mangan. Back to Phil Mangan. Shoots! Save right on! As Bryce Swan was draped all over the goaltender, Tardif. He's in a rhythm now for sure. Number 29 in red. As Brett Morrison, the other Centivex forward.
And with Swan in front of that net, he's got a good set of hands. If there's any rebound at all, he's just going to try to knock that one home. But once again, you might see Swan push off just a little bit to get away for that one-timer.
Off the puck drop, set of extra control, the face-off, Pageau. Waiting, winding, firing, save made by Tardif. Oh, that rebound was there for the taking. But Bryce Swan not able to track it down. Here is Mangan. He winds his way in. Slick little move. Steps in as he was hooked up. Mangan will pump it back to the blue line where Morrison will occupy. Now Morrison looks to Mangan, top of the right circle. Center point feed again to Morrison. He looks to Mangan on the far circle, back to Morrison. Now to Pageau, to Mangan. Centivex will work it now to Pageau on that near circle. There's a drive by Mangan. It goes wide of the goal. Pageau stepping in off the point, can't play it. Held in by Mangan. There's an opportunity for McGill to get that puck out. That could cost them. Across to Mangan on the left circle. Down low to Pageau. He looks. Won't shoot it. Up top. Swan scores! Bryce Swan scores in overtime. It's a power play goal. And the X-Men defend the Keating Cup and win it by a 6-5 final.
And again, we talked about it. Perhaps Swan would push off just a little bit, get that pass, take the shot. And that's exactly what happened. He missed one earlier from the point, the rebound just off his stick, but a good win there for Centivex in overtime is a good game for both teams getting back after the Christmas break.
Now, certainly, I said a costly non-clearing attempt, and it certainly came back to bite the McGill Redmen, but certainly a great way for Centivex to get the second half of the season started, and they'll find their rhythm and get back into it. They're going to be braced for a tough second half.
Absolutely. They started the year 4-0, and, the AUS is such good hockey. And every game, every team is, any team can win on any given night. X just have to keep it going and get a good seeding for the playoffs.
Pageau picked up an assist, as did Phil Mangan. The goal scorer, Bryce Swan. And so he wins it for the X-Men. 6-5 is the final, and the Centivex X-Men will win the Keating Cup and defend their title. And the X-Men are back in action in the regular season on the 7th and 8th of January. They're right here at the Millennium Center in Antigonish. They'll play the Moncton Blue Eagles and the St. Thomas Tommies. For Paul McDonald, I'm Ken McNeil. Hope you enjoyed the broadcast tonight as the Centivex X-Men winners in overtime, the final, 6-5.